Hello, ladies and gentlemen, it's Yu Yong here, and welcome to part 1 of Xbox 720 Rumors Timeline. As some of you may know, rumors for this console are all over the place. So much so, in fact, that I had to have 41 tabs opened in my web browser at the same time for my research portion, which is pretty ridiculous. In this video, part 1, I'll be talking about rumors from 2011 to 2012. In the next video, part 2, I'll talk about all the rumors from 2013. There's a lot to take in here, so feel free to take some notes. Alright, you ready? Let's dive right into it. August 15th, 2011, website Semi-Accurate reports that moles within Microsoft have managed to leak the name of the next Xbox's SoC, or System on Chip. Semi-Accurate reports that whispers have used the name OBED for Microsoft's new chip, said to be powered by AMD graphics, with IBM heavily involved in its design. The article also reports the final design for the chips is scheduled for early 2012, and that mass production is set for late 2012 or early 2013. December 5th, 2011. Semi-Accurate reports that the first few SoCs are pretty much finalized. They also discover that Microsoft has yet to reach out to developers about their new system, leading them to believe that the console may release in the second half of 2013. The article also rectifies the name of the SoC. Whispers previously called it OBED, but it is clarified to be OBAN. January 18th, 2012. Semi-Accurate confirms that the OBAN chips have now gone into initial production, likely for the creation of development kits. It is also stated that developers have been briefed about the new system shortly after the OBAN chip was okayed. Semi-Accurate also makes a few assumptions about the hardware. CPU is assumed to be an x86 chip because of IBM's involvement, and GPU is assumed to fall in line with ATI's HD 7000 series. At around the same time, website Fuzzilla hears similar rumors from its sources about OBAN and its production schedule. Website Fuzzilla proceeds to add that development kits can be expected sometime in March or April of 2012. Fuzzilla emphasizes that revisions to hardware are likely as the new chips are tested. January 24th, 2012, IGN's own sources also confirm that mass production of the OBAN chip will begin at the end of 2012, but unlike the previous articles, IGN sources state that the GPU will derive more from the 6000 series, specifically the HD 6670, which features DirectX 11 and multi-display support, 3D, and 1080p output. IGN proceeds to add that graphics performance for the new console is expected to be 6 times greater than that of the Xbox 360. January 25th, 2012. Kotaku's own Whispers reports with confidence that the next Xbox will upgrade to a Blu-ray drive. It is also reported that the next Xbox will ship with a Kinect successor, which houses its own onboard processor, allowing the device to detect users' motions more effectively. Kotaku also reports performance details close to IGN's figures, with their sources stating that the console will be 8 times more powerful than the Xbox 360. Furthermore, one of Kotaku's industry sources states that Microsoft intends to ban used games for the console. Kotaku also assumes that this could possibly mean that games will be linked to specific Xbox Live accounts. February 10th, 2012. Website CVG reports information obtained through Xbox Magazine stating that the next Xbox controller will include an HD touchscreen in the center, surrounded by traditional Xbox 360 buttons and sticks. It is also stated that the next Xbox will emphasize on bringing games to life with augmented reality, directional sound, and a new 4-player finger tracking Kinect. The article concludes by saying that all these features will culminate into an expensive device. February 28th, 2012, Crytek Senior Technical Director Sean Tracy tweets the codename for the next Xbox, the Durango. The tweet has since been deleted. March 9th, 2012, website NVC reports information obtained from a source stating that the Durango will not include a disk drive, relying solely on digital medium. The source also states that this is the strictest form of NDA they have ever seen. Furthermore, the article states that a 2013 launch window is pretty much confirmed. April 2nd, 2012, website VG247 reports that through third-party sources, they have learned that the Durango will require constant internet connection to function. It is also stated that it will feature a Blu-ray drive, built-in Kinect, and powerful hardware such as a CPU with 4 to 6 cores along with 2 GPUs equivalent to AMD HD 7000s that will work simultaneously. The website also reports to have learned a release date of Christmas 2013. June 16, 2012, a 56-page document of the Durango presented on August of 2010 is discovered on document-sharing website Scribd. The document mentions notable features such as Xbox Smart Glass, TV recording, Metro dashboard, a Blu-ray drive, full 1080p output with 3D support, 6x increase in performance, cloud-based gaming, and an improved Kinect system that sees the living room by sensing depth of objects within the room. The document also touches upon some of the console's specs, talking about using either 6 to 8 cores clocked at 2 GHz each, 4GB of DDR4 RAM, and 3 PPC cores clocked at 3.2 GHz for backwards compatibility. The document also states that the next Xbox will aim for a price of $299.99, shipped with version 2 of Kinect. This new Kinect is said to feature improved cameras, higher accuracy in tracking, stereo imaging, improved voice recognition, 4 players tracking support, and dedicated hardware processing. The document also mentions Project Fortaleza, described as Kinect glasses. The peripheral is said to allow augmented reality that will interact with Kinect 2. It is also said that it will somehow interact with Wi-Fi or 4G. The device is given a release window of 2014, after the holiday 2013 launch of the next Xbox. The 56-page document has since been removed from Scribd after Microsoft's own request. July 3, 2012. Microsoft secures ownership of multiple domains pertaining to the name Xbox 8. Rumors quickly surfaced that this is the Durango's final name, falling in line with Microsoft's new products, Windows 8 and Windows Phone 8. Furthermore, some have noted that the next Xbox is being developed for the 8th generation of video game consoles, which could explain the name Xbox 8. July 10, 2012, a patent filed by Microsoft in late June is discovered by NeoGAF and Beyond3D forum users. IGN analyzes the patent to find that it echoes much of the information found on the 56-page document, such as a new depth-sensing Kinect equipped with an in-house processor and multiple dedicated CPUs for the console. The patent states that some of these CPUs will be dedicated to specific functions, such as multimedia, allowing for features in the 56-page document like streaming and recording while gaming. Strangely, absent from the patent mentioned in the document is cloud streaming. July 29, 2012. Images of the Durango's development kit leak to the internet and is attempted to be sold for $10,000 by Assembler Games Forums user Day. Digital Foundry from Eurogamer contacts the user, along with various Durango developers, to confirm that these images are indeed the real deal, thereby confirming the codename Durango. Digital Foundry describes the development kit as an anonymous-looking black box similar to a PC with a simple interface akin to the Matrix. Forums user Day also proceeds to provide sketchy information such as the fact that he reckons the machine is 64-bit in nature and that it features an 8-core Intel CPU and an NVIDIA GPU along with 8GB of RAM. Digital Foundry notes that specs provided by Day are hard to believe considering how different the specs are from the current Xbox 360 and considering no signs of an NVIDIA and Intel matchup for Durango are present anywhere. August 10, 2012, Day leaks a screenshot taken from Kinect 2.0. The image shows a crisper image and a higher resolution compared to what is found on the current Kinect. Furthermore, the screenshots show better depth detection and body tracking, showing individually tracked fingers. August 13, 2012, Day sells one of 2 Durango development kits for $20,100 on eBay. September 4, 2012. Website SemiAccurate reports that the Durango may be delayed from what its sources state to be a September 2013 release date due to manufacturing problems of the Oban chip. Of the many manufactured chips, yield of usable chips is very low. November 21, 2012. Website The Verge reports that alongside the Durango, Microsoft is creating an Xbox set-top box. This low-cost alternative is designed to provide access to core entertainment services. The device is set to run on core components of Windows 8 with the ability to play casual games and downloadable games, but not hardcore retail Durango games. November 30, 2012. Website Bloomberg reports that according to sources familiar with the company's plans, the new console is planned to launch in time for Thanksgiving and Christmas sales. Furthermore, it is revealed that Microsoft is still deciding on whether to reveal the console at a major event such as E3 or to host their own event. And there you have it, folks. Every relevant Xbox 720 rumor from 2011 to 2012. Look forward to part 2, in which I'll talk about all rumors from 2013. To be further updated on next generation consoles, be sure to join the Nation and subscribe to Young Gear. I also cover AAA games and review them. Also, look forward to my game cinemas, such as the upcoming Skyrim movie Dragonborn, coming on summer of 2013. I'll see you guys next time. Thank you very much. Andy Young out.